Hi, me again, and I'm here talking about next year's Samsung Galaxy S8. You may have found it hard not to notice all the rumours flying around recently. In fact, there have been so many that we've had to make a new video on what our very own Sean Keach called a leak bonanza. Let's start with the release date. The flagship S-series smartphones are normally revealed at MWC in Barcelona at the end of February, and we're not expecting anything different here, although Samsung will be keen to move on quickly from the smouldering PR disaster that was the Note 7, so don't be surprised if it's a little earlier, as this tweet suggests, or a little later as they might want to make sure it works first without blowing up. Getting over the Note 7 debacle will take a phone that will explode in review scores rather than in your pocket. And for this reason, most likely, we probably won't see a battery-hungry 4K screen, which had been rumoured and all but guaranteed until the Sam Mobile blog post dispelled it. Instead, it will be a Super AMOLED QHD or 2K display, which will be plenty for a smartphone. And VR fans, don't panic, as the same blog post suggested it will move from a diamond pentile pixel layout to a standard RGB arrangement, which will see a noticeable improvement on your Gear VR. It could also see the home button disappear, as this concept render suggests. With a smaller bezel or no bezel at all, it does mean that the screen will be larger without increasing the phone's footprint significantly. So expect a screen size greater than the 5.1 inches currently on the S7 and the 5.5 on the S7 Edge. We've also discovered that the headphone jack will disappear, just like the iPhone 7. Cue another global outcry. And with it comes the introduction of a new USB-C port, which will allow faster charging and be used with a range of accessories. The S7 camera was incredible and contributed to the 10 out of 10 we gave it in our review. There was a rumour of a dual camera, and while this is still a potential on the Edge or other variants of the base model, it seems unlikely that the S8 will do the double. However, to set itself apart from the crowd, you'll also be able to do the same with an unprecedented auto-focusing selfie camera, a first for any smartphone to date. Moving on to specs, Snapdragon 830, Qualcomm's next flagship chip, is likely to be used, marking a 40% improvement on the S7. Running Android 7 Nougat, it will also sit atop the smartphone RAM stakes, matching the OnePlus 3 and 3T with a massive 6GB. Finally, after pairing up with car tech firm Harman, we may see dual speakers, again just like the iPhone 7. It isn't clear whether the Harman deal has anything to do with this, and we also don't know where the speakers will be mounted, but it will certainly improve on the S7 audio setup if this is true. Now, nothing is for certain, so take all this with due caution, but we'll of course keep you updated with all the latest leaks of what's looking like one hell of a handset. Stay tuned to trusted reviews.